How's it going, everybody? Kyther here, and welcome back to another episode of Satisfactory. Last time we made our crystal oscillator factory, which is in this box here, which you can also see is currently not running because we have wandered out of the quartz. We need to do some quality of life things to start off today. We also made this tower of construction for the steel pipes. As many as crystal oscillators as we have, so we should have probably had a lot more by the end of last episode, but that's not the case because we need to get this back up and running with this guy. However, today we have, well, not unlocked, but the game has been updated again. Update number 2, trains and nuclear power. And by which in any means, we are absolutely not ready for this, as we still haven't even gotten as far as doing, getting the guns working and whatnot, the radar technology. However, tier 6, who wants to click it? We have a monorail technology. We have the trains, which we can unlock. Ooh, we might be able to, I don't know if we'll be able to build any of this, but we definitely have enough stuff laying around to unlock it. And so unlock it, we shall indeed do. Let's get off the monorail train. Hoopadoosh. Oops. Press no buttons.
Milestone reached. A new set of buildings and vehicles needed for long-range transportation has been made available. In addition to built-in power conduction, rails-based transit ensures increased efficiency and reliability for both the transport of pioneers and cargo.
Yes, because not that I've had much trouble with them, but the vehicles are kind of, not necessarily dodgy, but kind of dodgy. So let us have a look-see at what we got. Going to vehicles, the railed vehicles. We have a railway, which we can make. Empty platform, can make. Okay, so maybe we can make this stuff. I just don't, yeah, computers. Things crowding. We got a freight platform. This is just empty. I know a little bit about these. As a freight car stop, they will enter, unload, or load their goods, depending on what you set. Set to railway each other train stations. This is a train station. Locomotives can be set to drive this stop to end stop at the train station. You can connect power to the train station to power up the trains on the railway, as well as transport the power to other stations. If it's a freight car, must be built on railway. And the locomotive requires 25 to 110 megawatts of power to drive. Nicknamed Leafy. Leafy? Leafy? Yeah. Wait, do they have the nickname? Yeah, so that one's nicknamed the Sugar Cube. And this one's just the unit. Didn't know, this one doesn't seem to have one in there. Interesting, but yes, the cool thing about these is the train stations and all the railways connect via power. So if we were to put a train station here and just chuck another one up here and connect it, this one has power, and that's how we can power the entirety of the island and also keep all our power connected together if we were to make other outpost power things. So we're going to have to watch our power, because if a train stops, we're in trouble. But anyway, like I mentioned, we have some quality of life things to do. We need to get you back up and running, and also just toggle that one on, so both of these productions can continue. For some reason, I'm guessing the things have updated, and this is here. Hopefully, it doesn't require me to redo this thing. I suppose we can check. Also, out of curiosity, do you still have stuff in here? You do. Okay, well, good to know. But I am going to reset up the truck route for this. Alright, so I have both of them running now, and realized that I didn't have the fuel connected to them anymore, so I just crudely putting it in roundeth under there. Let's put this back on. I had a bit of a problem with this one, but all sorted. We kind of had a bit of a crash, but again, we're fine. forgot that I have this at 60 belt. Maybe I should up it so it goes through faster. I'm hoping this one had, well, this one had fuel in it, the other one didn't. So he should be coming back ish. He just came back, so he has fuel because I jumped some of my own in there. So we'll be good on that front. And I suppose pressing all the wrong buttons, whack a door here as well, just so we can get in from this side into here. As we can see, there's indeed running. Continue filling up and going into here. I've also slightly lowered the render distance. The game's getting a bit choppy. So, as I've said in the past, the quality of the game, or just the looks of the game, may change a little bit. Just so I find a spot that it's running a little bit more smoothly, but those stutters that happened just then, they're kind of normal at this point for me. So as we got rid of this middle platform last episode, it's time to get rid of the top one, as well as these two floating platforms. And I think for the time being, they might just get relocated to up here, which in of itself, this tower too will probably very well be changing in the future, because I has plans for it. And I do have to say, that definitely makes this place look a lot cleaner. One other thing that I noticed, it was in their patch, well, was it the update notes, not patch notes, is that we actually have, I saw it in here too, foundations. We have a 8 meter by 1 meter foundation. It is, that's the one we've been using. What's this one? Oh, so it's just one thick. That works so much better for like in between floors. So much better. It'd make the dodginess of this one look so much better in where the fuel line goes. Cool. Well, I will be replacing that. Can I click it? I'll be replacing that in places then. That is amazing. So, with the housekeeping out of the way, is there anything else in here that's been updated? Not that I've seen, or can see, I should say. They've also... Wait, obelisk. I suppose it's in there twice? Is it in there twice because I've done the thing twice? Maybe? Not too sure. So only the hard drives, which I should go looking for. But I think I kind of want to actually focus on getting these tiers done. My mouse is failing me and not clicking. So of all the things, we just need to create some nobelisks. So we need to create a black powder factory. Oh boy. Which we need the sulfur and the coal. And we're not using either of them at the moment. So that's beautiful. Sulfur's being brought there. We'll probably do something similar with the coal. And oh geez, that is a great, it's like the best and most worst spot for it to have gone. What I think we'll do though is I might remove this building and make it over that way, closer to where the actual stuff is mined. The limestone is mined. Maybe. I mean, that's all going to change. Everything over here is going to change. Like that. I don't know if that'll change or not. Power plant. But anyway, let me work out where we're going to put this building so we can get some explosives into production. And here is Exhibit A of trucks freaking out. Oh, I see. This is grown here. That's not good. We drive truck. We can flip it over. Alright, buddy. We need you to try not run me over. Yeah, okay. I feel like you're off path somehow. I don't know which one this is and where you're trying to go. I definitely want me some nobelisks to blow up the trees and especially this rock, actually. Let's see if you will. Okay. I don't know what just happened. I don't know where I is. Well, apparently I'm here. Am I falling? This is interesting. I presume I'd be falling. Oh, now everything's just gone. Uh-oh. Alright, so I just essentially just loaded the last quick save that happened. That was very, very weird. But as you can see, trucks freak out. And I'm also wondering if that's because trees definitely grew back. I didn't really get a good look of what was going on there. Just the fact that I got into that truck and that happened, that's even weirder. What exactly happened? Where is truck? Again, I also don't know which truck it was. I presumably it is a soft one. Yes, so this tree is definitely growing back. Do I have chainsaw? I do. Let's chop it down and fix this issue. Alright, Mr. Truck. You can drive on through now pretty damn cleanly. All I can guess is that they adjusted the map. I think they said they adjusted, maybe not specifically those trees, but they've adjusted some things, and I'm just, all I can guess is that was potentially one of them. But he seems fine now. Right, back to what I was doing and setting up trying to find an area for these explosives. Alright, so I decided to put it just where the sulfur comes in, so next to what is essentially our rubber factory at the moment, down here on this giant piece of square land, which we'll leave too wide here for the road to go. So we have this, a bigger square here. Now, I don't know how much we need, and another cool thing that we have is if we press X, we get this index and tutorials list, but they've added a recipe list here too. We can actually see what we need for things and how much they make. We make 7.5 a minute. And for the Nobelisk, we are wanting to 10. But then there's just two of these machines running. Although I probably want to be making these. Maybe two of these. Was it 7.5? Not a nice number at all, but I think this will be large enough. Also, I just want something to maybe either whether we go flush up again. Actually, we go flush up against here because I'll bring this floor up at one point and he can just drive straight between a row of buildings, provided that the truck stays here. Let me work out exactly what we're doing and I will bring you guys back then. So I've almost made a grave error. I have set a rule for this city type place that one type of material item, whatever, will be making the building. This might be the only exception because the black powder is only used in the explosives, but I also am pretty sure it works for the rifle as well, for the bullets. We may make that in this building, and as far as I can tell, looking at what the recipe was and looking in the actual machines themselves, I'm gonna make two manufacturers for the Nobelisks, so we can be making 6 a minute, I believe it was. I think it's 3 a minute, which ends up being really nice round numbers. So we will need 4 assemblers for the black powder. And then a bunch of stuff that is over that way, being the pipes and the thing we made just last episode, the crystal oscillators, breaking so much. So I'm going to try a different tactic for building the building here. We're going to try and swipe it and time lapse it. And there we go. I don't know how well that will have turned out or how smoothly it would have been, but this is our setup, considering the black powder. We get 7.5, we need 15 per two of the, well, 15 per machine up there. And these numbers split so evenly, we only need 30 coal and then double that, so 60 sulfur. So the splitting is lovely. And you will also have noticed that we can now stack splitters, which is so useful, both the mergers as well, like they just, it's so beautiful. Take that. Yeah, I had to also extend the base platform out by one extra row so we could fit the splitting in here very nice and easily. The coal is kind of just coming in at very random indeed. So that just splitting it off from where it's going into the truck station, which it won't be going in there for all that much longer, really. And just splitting up, coming down here. The belt is the fastest belt possible that I have at the moment, which is the Mark 4, just because it can. It won't need to be that fast at all. It needs to be, both of these actually only need to be 60 lines. So we have way too much sulfur than I know what to do with at the moment. But anyway, that is a nice little quick setup of this. This now just needs to merge these two together, those two together, go up a floor. I don't know whether I want to leave space for another one of these. Might do. For the potential of needing more black powder in the future. Which I suppose they won't need to be 60s then, will they? Well, one will need to be 60, one will need to probably be doubled. But anyway, I shall add on another floor. I'm not sure what I'm doing for walls either. That's why that's just sitting there. Might do this form at the bottom. Or just do like a weird strip around it. I don't know. Also, standing here is dangerous. I've yet to be hit. But I am just waiting to be run over when I stand down there. But anyway, I shall work on the next floor. And there we go, having our second floor nice and ready. We'll get out of that. So, the alternate nobilisks, with the black powder which we're getting from down below, and then just need steel pipes and the crystal oscillators, which are going to be brought in from yonder that way. Possibly this entrance bit here might change. The only bit you guys didn't really see is the little back bit over here that has these bits. Let's see if we can't connect these, because they're obnoxious sometimes. We need to stand on top of the thing, otherwise you grab hold of the wrong thing. So, I said thing too many times just then. Anyway, we are open door living, apparently, because I don't have anything for the floors. I guess you guys see my little secret. How I'm taking photos and staying in exactly roughly the same spot. Screen bit, aiming it is a little bit difficult. Well, that's going to do that. Let's try and work out how to get these things over here. They'll probably have to cut through this corner, which is not going to be very nice when... Actually, no, because I can only fit two more oil things in here. Oil refineries, one per side, so... Cutting this corner won't be too bad. Again, wish they had one of the walls. They had one of these like on the very edge of it, so we could go around the outsides. But anyway. So we need to get a little bit of that over here. A little bit of that. And so as the sun sets, let's get this thing up and running. I've created a very quick abomination thing here. So we've only got about five of these going over there, since we only need three, so this will eventually back up. And so they'll probably take one of the longest. We shall plug that in. I have a line, as you can see, going over there for the beams here. Just need to plug those into there, which is already going to be too much for it. We jump down here. Take some damage And I suppose, since I only need 60 for now, let's take that out of there. We'll watch this go flying across the top of our heads momentarily. And just to keep things somewhat the same, connect that you, considering I have it on me, which is about what it's coming in at anyway. And all of this can start working. I've already hooked it all up to the power just by using that one over there. Same with up the top. Or going on with the black powder as well. Not gonna lie, freaked out when the coal wasn't coming through just yet. But maybe potentially working. Gonna take some time to go through. What about up here? They're not through just yet. Oh. Oh, but they are. Hello, my pretties. You get to go a long, long way by yourself, whereas they just go forever. Yep, and then this is just going to be backed up for a very long time. Presumably, that line's just going to keep going by the looks of it, by looking at this, because I should be having all of this. It shouldn't be merging back in here. It should be going back in the back of this. Essentially, this is just going to, yeah, it's going to start doing that. It's not going to be spreading them out all that equally. It'll be just a straight line. But anyway, given that enough time, this should be failing in, and we can see it being made and sent away. There we go. It's on the other side. The very first of the black powder being made successfully. 15, 1.5. In they come. They're going to be being separated. I saw one of the crystal oscillators go in there. We're just waiting on these two. The black powder is never going to back up because it is at an even. 7.5, it was 15. So that is our bottleneck, essentially. But it's not a bottleneck if it's running at 100. Well, air quotes, 100% efficient. Oh, there we go. We're working. The novelisks are being made. 15 a minute, not 15 per thing. And take 40 seconds to make. So, yeah, not too bad. I just don't need a super massive stack of them. Let's see, 4.5 a minute, 9 a minute. Yeah, a little bit, because I need 50 of them to be put into the MAM. They're not even put into the MAM, to be helped sent off so we can get our next whip on. Is this completely backed up? Yeah, that's exactly what I was expecting for that up there to do. To stagger in like that. It was kind of pointless. But to also put it out there, they've been made. That tower is going to be huge for these things, the crystal oscillators. Because what are we producing? We're producing like just above 5, I think, a minute. Yeah, it's like 2.8 per machine. And this one is consuming 3. So 1.2 of the other machines, so we're only having 2 in there that we're not using. Ay, that is scary. So we're going to need a lot more of them in the future, I'm guessing. But now we have technically 12 Nobelisks. If I grab that, by the time I go here and grab this one, it should technically also is indeed ready. So, with that, I'm going to let them stockpile up for a little bit, and then we shall unlock the, I don't remember specifically what it was called, but the gun weapon. Look at these adorable little things. Just as a temporary solution as well, because I don't know what I want to do with storage for this place. These things. We'll just convene them all over into this storage bin, which will probably bite me later. But there we go. We have 54 of these. I don't remember what else exactly we needed to put in. I think for the rifle is what it was called. I also fixed this thing so it's not going to be streaming out them those things forever. Eventually they'll back up. Let me grab the things that are necessary, and we shall send the rocket off once again. So we almost had a bit of a catastrophe there, because I don't think I have any wire being stored up. But I still have this little container here from one of our first bins. Let's say we two. That is B3, and I will take the rest, because I will need wire later. There we go, so Ahana has everything. Let's just run on over to our hub, which, ooh, I was considering we might move it to down. Oh, I didn't mean to fall down. Momentum carried me then. Considering to putting it down here, but then again, I want to try and keep it central in the base city, this place, whatever we want to call it. We haven't given it much thought. Those base in general is what most people would be calling theirs. Add in all of the cable, that, and that, the rifle, ready to launch. Give me the information.
Rifles can now be crafted at the workbench. They require cartridges to function. I am now obligated to inform you of FICSIT rifle policies. Note, aim the barrel away from your body. It is the part with the hole in it. Note, assume all alien life is hostile. Note, R&D's ballistics lab has a recommended music playlist on FICSIT servers.
Cool. I guess she's like, I shall give you the information you need. Proceeds to sort of give a delay to that. Alright, right, I can make it. I will make it. I was not expecting to have the things on me to make it. That is a surprise. But has a rifle. There's a cartridge. Oh no, the cartridge wants these. Ew. Well, let's make a couple of them then. Well, that's easy peasy done. Use all of them. And let's try this bad boy out, shall we? I've lost it. Where did it go? Oh, hello. Little tick. Adorable. Oh. Cool. Cha-ching. Shall we reload it? Very, very forceful with this. We have like a... No, we don't have a zoom. Wondering if we right-clicked if we zoomed or not. Then I presume it's just... Whap, whap. Poosh, poosh. What be in here? Anything different? No. So I know in the experimental build that they have, you were able to get a Mark II rifle. Okay, well that changes things. I wonder if there is a new recipe though that does a similar thing. We might quickly unlock, no, we'll do that next time because we are running out of time. Well that's fine. I won't need huge amounts of these. Okay, so jeez. This thing will just stay out forever. The magazines take more pipes. Which, how much were they exactly? I saw it was only the two things. So, provided I have... No, I don't have the things to make an assembly. Blur. Of course I don't. Well, good for me. There is one just down here. It's not going to tell... Nope, I need the things. And those two things can still be located in the bins that are down here. Well, not a lot anymore. Now, I want to see how they're made. So it's a 3 to 12, a 1 to 4 ratio. Makes it in 20 seconds. What is the nebulous making over there? It's making 4.5, so we're making way more. I'll probably just make one of these machines over there on the next floor up, so then we can store these and make those. 12 pipes. 12. Does anything need 3 pipes specifically overloaded? I feel like there was something. I don't remember what that is. Well, anyway, let's quickly tack on to the top of our building a new assembly maker for the cartridges. Alright, so to grab our pipes, I decided we would just merge all 3 of these into the one line and take it over. It'll be more than enough, because I only need really 12 of the 15. And when they come into the area here, we're just going to split them off so they go up a level. It wasn't perfectly straight, but it works. And then, you see I sort of changed my mind about it. And then they can sort of just come in nicely, merge into here. Herbalisks have already filtered in. And then I'm just going to add two storage containers. Add one there and one here. So the Nobilisks can stack up along there. They come in from both sides, just merge in, just so this one here is just always full. And we're gonna have the cartridges filter on in here. Look at them tiny little things. In they go. Where has storage done? The building itself is not done. It is a very bodgy dodge. Lidan building, as it is just completely floating, but we like legitimately completely floating. The only thing that would be holding any structural support are these, you know, vertical lifts, which they themselves don't even touch the ground. So yeah, magic floating building. We will actually, I might just base this next between this episode and the next one. And I'll just show you what it's going on about. But this is our very tiny weapons factory, is probably what I'll title this episode. Because it works. It's all weaponized. We have these. That's not what goes in there. We have Dicka. I don't have the other thing on me as of right now. Or do I? It was meaning to actually place it in, not swap it. But anyway, that is going to be it for today, I believe. Whoosh. Pretty productive. Again, really only made one building, but we have automated. Technically three things. For the black powder, which we will never ever grab for no reason. I have dismantled the rail to make concrete for the time being on accident, essentially. We're coming over here. I rock. Reload. I press the wrong button here. Watch me. And reload again. Any other rocks that want to be just taken away? Baboosh. That did actually work too. Nice. Hello. Tiny little rock. I feel like... It's like... Are you... like, are you dumb? The thing's not actually there. That rock just doesn't... That thing does not matter. In the slightest. But anyway, guys, that's gonna do it for today. Bop. As if that would do anything. I wonder if that thing is either impervious to damage... Or maybe you can take it down. I don't know. Probably don't want to anger that thing if it is the case that you can hurt it. I would not know. Oop. But anyway, that is going to do it for today. Hopefully you have enjoyed it. If you did, please feel free to stick around, see some more. And take this away now as well. Because that can all go up here. Well, I accidentally sort of managed to save that. And I've used it. Oh, there we go. Because I've used enough to not warrant doing that. Give me a full stack of ammo. Thank you very much. We will make use of these possibly next time. Because if I'm able to, we will either aim to do some work on some train stuff. Well, I think, again, before that, we need to get the computer's up and running, and the heavy modular frames, speaking of which, pressing all the wrong buttons, because we need computers to do the things, but we might have enough, we have enough stuff to actually work without having to get those things started up again. I just need to make myself some more beacons, and we have a ton of these steel beams. Righteth. I was gonna say downeth there, but my behind this, isn't it? Yeah. Behind this building, the 1, 2, 3 full storage silos of these things, containers. Plus half a normal one, nearly half. So we got the time to do the rails, and I'll probably at the same time, well, this needs to be higher, but I might just get one of these to just be making pipes constantly into a storage buffer down below. Probably do it with that one, because we're going to need it for the trains. But anyway, that's all. Hopefully you've enjoyed that. If you did, please feel free to stick around and see some more. And I shall see you guys next time. But until then, bye.